Hello, my merry friends. It is Hecking Tuesday. On this Hecking Tuesday, we are going to read one of Shakespeare's sonnets. Or rather, Shakespeare's sock. Anyway, number 135. A beautiful specimen, really. I had to read it and do a project on it for English class, and I was actually very pleased with it. So I'm enthusiastic enough about it to make a video on it. So here we go. I'm going to read it, and then I'm going to briefly summarize it, and then I'm going to tell you my thoughts on it. Whoever hath her wish, thou hast thy will, and will to boot, and will in overplus. More than enough am I that vex thee still, to thy sweet will making addition thus. Wilt thou, whose will is large and spacious, not once vouchsafe to hide my will in thine? Shall will in others seem like gracious, and in my will no fair acceptance shine? The sea, all water, yet receives rain still, and in abundance addeth to his store. So thou, being rich in will, add to thy will, one will of mine to make thy large will more. Let no unkind, no fair besiegers kill, think all but one, and me in that one will. Alrighty, so basically, very briefly, this poem is about the poet wanting to get in a lady's pants. But this, and also it's actually worse because he doesn't even want to replace the other guys that she's sleeping with. He just wants to become one of them. So although this is a crude seeming topic, and it is a crude topic, I guess, for, you know, society, it's actually a much sweeter poem than initially anticipated. So I'm going to tell you why I think that it's actually a sweet poem. And basically, so the first part is will. The word will. It appears 14 times in this 14 lines. And it can mean desire. So like my will, right? My will to live. My desire to live. But also, it in Shakespeare's day, it was slang for penis or vagina. Both, actually. So the double meaning is very important. In this poem. So anytime you see will, you should consider both meanings. So basically in the first part, like for example, like whoever hath her wish, thou hast thy will. So like whoever she likes has will and will to boot and will, so like has a big dick, but also has a lot of desire. See, these are two ways to look at it. And I think Shakespeare emphasizes the fact that you're supposed to look at both meanings by repeating the word will so many times, because, like, the word kind of gets jumbled in your head, and then the definition sort of gets jumbled in your head. Plus, if he didn't want you to consider both meanings, then he wouldn't have used the word will. He would have used different single-syllable words, if you know what I mean. If he was just referring to the genitalia, I mean. Yes. Okay. And then the other thing, besides considering both definitions, that makes it sweet, is the just look for like adjectives throughout, like, and descriptors, like thy sweet will, your sweet vagina, or sweet desire. Like that's a nice way to describe it. Wilt thou, whose will is large and spacious, once again, double meaning, like large desire, but also I mean like a nice vagina. Not once vouchsafe to hide my will in thine, like this means sex, but this is the nicest way I've ever heard of sex being put. It's very gentle. Like, it's not rough, right? Like, rough sex is a thing. But then, like, when I think of to hide my will in thine, or, like, even to hide my penis in your vagina, like, that brings to me an image of, like, gentle, smooth motion, and it's, like, not rough and not crude. Shall will in others seem right and gracious? That's, you know, describing will as gracious. That's a nice word as well. In my will, no fair acceptance shine. He's just looking for some fair acceptance. That's all he's looking for. And here we get to the meat of the poem. The sea, all water, yet receives rain still, and in abundance addeth to his store. So thou, being rich in will, add to thy will, one will of mine to make thy large will more. You'll notice here in line 4, to thy sweet will making addition thus, so that actually brings back to here, sort of, because this is all about addition, and this is just a brief mention. Anyway, here, basically what he's saying that the sea has a ton of water, an abundance of water, but it still receives more water. So you, who are abundant in will, so desire, or dicks, or, you know, I guess vagina, but I think dicks makes more sense here. Being rich in desire, add to your desire, or dicks. One dick desire of mine, to make your dick desire more. Or wait, vagina desire, sorry. But, like, it's actually very nice, because, like, this, again, it's not crude, right? This poem could have easily been a poem about, like, him wanting to take advantage of her, or something like that. But it's not. It's him. He just wants to be one of the guys, and he just wants to, like, make her more. He wants to increase her desires, or, like, I think desires is a good for here, but, I mean, if you look at the other definition, her, like, amount of dicks, I guess. But, yeah, and also, the sea is a very convenient metaphor, because there is also another liquid that is very present when there is desire, if you know what I mean. Let no one kind, no fair beseechers kill. Think all but one, and me in that one will. Not gonna lie, I'm not exactly sure what line 13 means. Here, the note on the side says, unkind means perhaps an unkind person or unkindness. Fair means handsome or honorable, and beseechers means suitors or suppliants. So, I guess, like, let no unkind and no handsome suitors kill. I'm not sure who they're killing or who they're not supposed to kill. But then, think all but one. So, it says, like, think of all your lovers as one lover. And include me in them. Or in that one desire. Or that one dick, I guess. If they're all one, then it's one dick. But also, this is beautiful. So this man, as it says right here, it's William Shakespeare. So Will is also short for William. So that's also another fun definition of the word will to look at in here. So yeah, that's thank you for coming to my TED talk. I'm sorry, it's past my bedtime. And yeah, so that's why I think this poem is actually sort of sweet and not as bad as it may seem. Lacey, I will see you tomorrow.